Hello and welcome to a brand new video. Today we're going to be reviewing ARMS for the Nintendo Switch, the brand new Nintendo IP that was released back in 2017 around June. So now we're finally going to be taking a look at it, even though the game is really old at this point. But it recently got an update, so I feel like it's still kind of within justice to make a video about it right now. So we're going to jump over to that screen right there. Right there, and we're going to be reviewing ARMS for the Nintendo Switch, even though I've said that 1,000 times at this point, but, yeah. ARMS for the Nintendo Switch. We are currently on version 5.2.0. That means that we have the newest character, which is very creepily looking at us with her boyfriend, I believe that's who it is, Max Brass, but let's not try and overcrowd you. Oh! Shoot! I didn't know they announced this. But, let's talk about that, I guess, because the game wants us to start off with talking about that. Party Crash was a thing added later on in the development of the game. Not development, but release of the game. Like, early, like, winter, fall, and fall. Once the leaves turn orange, they started making this, and they're basically like Splatfest for Splatoon, except in ARMS. You go up to 30, and you can get badges themed to the character that you prefer to fight with. And I will probably be choosing Max Brass for this one. There are different events that go on every, like, 10 minutes. And different ARMS give you more points if you use them, and if you use the two characters for that event, you also get more coins. But yeah, that's Party Crash, but let's take her one step back and talk about the characters. So there is currently 15 characters choosable, and that'll probably be the ending amount for this game, because pretty sure Nintendo said that was it for characters, and so far that has been true, but we have Springman, Ribbon Girl, Nindra, Master Mummy, Min-Min, Mechanica, Twintel, Bite and Bark, Kid Cobra, Helix, Max Brass, Lollipop, Nisango, Springtron, and Dr. Coil. There's also Random, which will randomly select your character, as you can see. Each character has a custom color. I'm not going to show all of them. You can look that up yourself. But as you can see, each character does swap out its normal palettes for something else. And each character has certain ARMS that are accustomed to them, except for Springtron, because he is a clone of Springman. Anyway, each one of them has their own ARMS, and you can use other characters' ARMS on a different character. And you can also upgrade them to do 10 more damage. As you can see, all of them are upgraded. And yes, so Grand Prix, you can choose a character and choose level 1, 2, 3, and anywhere between there you will end up facing Max Brass and going through a lot of the characters, because there's only 10 rounds, and you do minigames or one-on-one matchups with them. Levels 4 and 5, you face Headlock, which is some sort of demon spawn thing. You don't want to run into that guy, let me just say that. And levels 6 and 7, after beating Headlock, you face Dr. Coil. So, it gets a little intense. Just kidding, sorry about that. It is Dr. Coil you face, not Max Brass. That's why the symbols are different. And, yes, so 7 is the hardest, 1 is the easiest. And that is pretty much the story mode you get here. I'll start up Kid Cobra, why not? And kind of show you the beginning. So you start off, you're like, woo! Yay! Grand Prix! And then it shows you this clip for the character and talks about the background of each character. Ladies and gents, Slytherin over here, blah 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 blah. Yeah, you get the point. And it tells you a bio about the character and a little bit more about him right there. But that'll be in my episode of him. And this is match 1. There's 10 matches on levels 1 through 3. and you start off by facing Springman. All of the characters you face are random, and the first stage is your own stage. After that, they're all at your opposing character's stage. And you choose your arms, it's kind of the point of the game, but yes, you get it. You should. If you don't. To go to Versus, Grand Prix can also be played on two-player. Win 10 fights as a team to become champs. Basically said what that mode is. In Fight, you can choose between the time, which is no limit, or 99. So, not a whole lot of options for time, at least right now. You can fight two matches, or just win one. You can have items on, and the items are electric, and bombs, and health, and HP up, or rush gauge up. Health, you can have it so it's normal, infinite, or one punch KO. Rush gauge, you can have it so that it's full, or not even there at all. And you can have computers up to 3, 4-player max, and yes. So we'll show a little bit of that. So I'm going to be my favorite character right over here. And then I'm going to have my second favorite character, Ribbon Girl. There are 15 different stages. The Spring Stadium, which is Springman, of course. Ribbon Girl, Ribbon Ring, Ribbon Girl, you get the point. Ninja College, Mausoleum, I don't know how to say that. Ramen Bowl, Scrappy Yard, Cinema, Ducks, Buster Beach, Snake Park, DNA Lab, Sky Arena, Vile Dulce, Temple Grounds, Sparring Ring, and Name Reacted. Redacted. I don't know how to say that word. And of course, random. We're going to do random, and it randomly selects from the 15 stages and puts you in them. This is by far one of the most creepy stages. Not my favorite, but definitely kind of an eerie stage. So there is no for real story mode. And this is what rush gauge is. So there's many different options for control in this game. I added on one punch KO. And you can charge up your arms by dashing, jumping, or blocking. A lot of different options there. And I won. Your rush gauge, I'll show that right now, and then we'll move on from this mode. So you can select different arms, mix-match them, all that jazz, as you can see she did, and then use your move, punch as many times as you want, and it's not that strong in the regular mode, but I added on one punch KO. You can change your arm sizes in versus mode as well, and you get money based on what you do, but let's go to the other modes. Team fight is 2-on-2. I don't think we really need to show that because I kind of already showed that. Just regular fighting. Volleyball, you use your arms to punch a ball and eventually it does pop. So we'll play that one just for a quick second. With the same exact fighters. Hit the ball with both arms to set it up, then hit it again to spike it. So it's basically volleyball. No big surprise there. And it's 1st to 5, or whoever's winning after a minute. You punch it over, and if they don't hit it, you get a point. And the bomb does eventually explode after, I believe, 30 seconds, so if it's a very close game, it eventually won't happen. There is no tiebreaker, sadly, so if you guys both end up at 3 when time ends up, then it's a tie. And that's volleyball. Yeah. There's no items available in volleyball, like team fight and fight. You have hoops, where you are the basketball, and there is no basketball provided to you. So let's take a look at hoops. Buzzer beaters totally count, and indeed they do. Similar to basketball, anything beyond the three-point line is 3 points, and anything in front of it is 2 points. So you get the gist. So I get 2 points because she's in the 2-point range. If she would come out here, could you please show the beautiful audience of YouTube? There we go. Grabbed her within the 3-point line and 3 points. You get the gist. You can use your move also to rack up your points. She, of course, can grab me. Not a big surprise there. There is, I believe, only three items in this game. The bomb, electric bomb, and it is first 1 to 10. Whether you go over it or hit 10, they count it. And you can use your move, like I said before, to get points. And that is hoops, or basketball. Because it's not really called hoops in real life. Although some people do call it that. Skill shot, you hit a bunch of targets, and they go up and down and move around. I'll show that a bit later in a different but similar mode. You can do doubles or singles in this one, unlike hoops. Headlock Scramble, you use that mask, which you face him in the level 4 and up modes of Grand Prix, and the mask spawns in, and then you can grab it on and wear it, and eventually it does go away. You can do... I don't think you can do doubles. But you can do 4 players, so that works too. Well, let me see. So I don't have enough controllers, but... Anyway. After Headlock Scramble, you have 1 in 100, and you have to face 100 of these suckers. Pretty intense stuff right there. And eventually you face a headlock with its head on them. Pretty intense. On this, you test out arms. So whatever arms you want to do and whatever maps, it does it for you. You can go on a win streak, but it doesn't really do anything to lock much. But it's practice for arms. Basically, if you're new to the game. Party match, you fight online for fun. Basically what I just said there. Exactly what I said. Oh, never mind. I don't have a good connection here, I guess. Try and show it one more time. Originally when the game came out, there was only 10 characters, so they've added a lot of new stuff. You can fight online and all that jazz. And it looks like I'm going to be fighting Frisco. Let's cut ahead to after me beating him, hopefully. There is a warm-up mode that you can use as well. It looks like I'm stuck in another match. And that's pretty much party match. You pretty much just go at it. There's win streaks if you win a bunch in a row. And there's every single mode that I've already talked about in this. It gets pretty intense. You don't unlock levels or anything. But it does give you money for playing, so eventually you could buy stuff. But I haven't really talked about what you can buy, so let's cut to that after I... Once again, hopefully beat these guys. And I won that one, so let's leave. And you can also do two-player, and it alternates, and it's a good time. So basically, buy this game. Ranked match, you do one-on-ones with people, no items available. And it's basically to see who really is the best. I'm at rank 11, and the max you can be is 20. So I'm not the best. But if you were to play, it would be hard for you to. Anyway, you can fight online with your friends. I've got a few online, and then a few that are also out there. You can create lobbies if your friends are not online. And you can do a party lobby, which makes you just fight, and you can do a bunch of customization. Or it can be similar to ranked match, where you fight one-on-one, and it gets pretty intense on that mode. Locally, you can face local people with your Switch, so if you have a friend over, or you're at a friend's party, or whatever is going on, you can do the exact same thing that you can do with online, except it's right there and you don't need any internet. Training, you can practice with the various modes available. You can do the basics, and it's just a bunch of stuff. Punching based, guarding, trading punches, not getting grabbed, rush practice, anti-jump practice, counter practice, and if you beat all of them, you get an achievement. So now that we're over here, we're going to start over with the help side of things. And it shows you the basic controls, modes, and rules. What's that about? Basically everything I've said right there. Tips and tricks gives you tricks on what to do. Fighters shows all of the fighters in the game, even the DLC ones. And here it shows a bunch of hidden stuff that you might not know about. For instance, changing your character's color, which is right here. Apparently there's a secret way to change a fighter's color when selecting one. So people had to actually find out how to do it because Nintendo didn't give it away. Here is the stats. It shows every version. So if you haven't bought the game and now you're going to buy it, it's probably only going to show level 5, and then all these will be blank, so it won't be as fun. But you get to compare all of your stats between versions, what kind of arms you used, what badges, what character you used the most, what level you were at, and provides for some pretty cool stuff. So when facing me, you have a 46% chance of winning. Interesting. Yeah. And then there's also the party crashes, so it shows all the featured fighters and who won and lost and all the badges you won, all the coins you won for that event, and then it shows thank you for fighting with the character that you chose. And so far there's been 6 of them, and 2 more remain. One of them has been announced and is about to happen, which we saw earlier, and one has yet to be named. The recent replays, it shows all the replays that you've done. I'm not sure completely how it works. It says they are automatically deleted in the order they were added, and will be deleted whenever it is updated, so I guess they update arms quite a lot because they only show like 4 rows max, so I don't know. But it shows every match that you've recently done, so not all of them like Mario Kart, and I don't believe you can fire with them either. Gallery is a very new mode that was added to the game, and it shows a bunch of tidbits and artwork for the game, as well as a little bit of story, which I find very interesting. It shows a bunch of confidential stuff, so if you have enough money, you can buy all this, and kind of gives the arms a bit more to the game, because as of right now, there isn't a lot of story. You can get badges for tons of stuff, for getting money, for punching a certain amount of times, for using certain arms, for beating Grand Prix, and fighting a certain amount of times. I don't know how many there are, but there is a ton. So that is the new badges or achievements. That's basically what they're called. Here you can change out your stuff. Pretty useful. And then lastly, like I said, I was going to show Skillshot. This is basically what Skillshot is. You can choose between a short, a medium, and a long timer. And you basically, this is how you get all the arms for the other characters. So if you wanted to use the Ram for Ninja, you would have to do this and hope, you don't get to choose, but hope that you hit it. So that's one of the critiques I have. You can't just buy whatever arms you want. You have to earn them by punching them through this mode. But yeah, so let's cut to one of the final parts of the video. One of the last things I wanted to show was the different controller options that there are. So you can either do motion controls where you punch to actually like punch in the game and move around and guard, all motion based. There's also sideways Joy-Cons, so if you like the tiny Joy-Cons, this is also an option. You can use them separate. And then the other option is Pro Controller or 2 Joy-Cons in the grip or undocked switch. Those are all the controls. You can also change them as well to whatever you prefer. This was not originally in the game, but it is now, and you can change the settings for each one, and they're all separate to each controller too, so it can get pretty intense. So that is it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. I know it wasn't the most interesting review, but I don't have the greatest software to make a good review, so please tell your friends about this video if you did even watch this. But that is ARMS, and I hope there's a sequel. I really do enjoy this game, and this is mostly a review, not what the game is, but I think this game is good and should be continued to be worked on by Nintendo. It has a decent fan base, but I don't think it has enough people like Splatoon did. But seriously, this game has some potential, and I hope it does get at least a sequel or a big expansion pass or something. ARMS Deluxe for the Nintendo Switch U, I don't know. But I think this game is worthy for something else, because I enjoyed it, my brother enjoyed it, and a lot of my family members and friends do enjoy this game. So hopefully ARMS gets reworked for a sequel at some point in the future. I think they should add story mode, obviously. That is something that really needs to be added in, just like with Smash 5 about to be coming out. But we're going to leave it with these guys dueling it out in hoops, And just imagine fighting on that. That'd be cool. More characters, of course. Maybe a tournament mode. More online functionality. But, yeah. More, please, Nintendo. That's my basic wish. That and a story mode. But anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. I have a Discord, Twitter, websites down below. All that junk. You know where it is. It's in the description. Thank you so much for watching. And in the next video, I will see you guys. Peace.